Checked out a lot of the people already, you know, like the voice actors and like other people. But right now, Kev is trying to get a signature for Jim Lee, so that's gonna be sick. What kind of comic are you looking for? Like an X-Men?
So the thing is, I could probably just go up there and just see if he definitely has sketches that he did for him to sign. So I could just do that. It'd be a little extra, but I'm fine with that. But that's if we don't find it. Yeah. So we're just trying to find that right now. Just something, because I have him at home, but your boy forgot. Mm-hmm. The dinosaurs. This is against nature. Nature will take its course. Everything is natural order. When it happens, you'll see.
We have Dante.
Oh yeah, we found this guy on the street in San Francisco.
I'm the Spider-Man.
He was over there swinging on 37th Street.
Hey yo, what the fuck is up? It's me fucking Spike Speed on from the Bebop. Yeah. You want an autograph? No? Alright. Hey, stop fucking recording. I asked fucking $2 per hour.
$2 per hour? I'm not gonna record you for an hour. Nah. But if I do get a picture, can I do it the Aki?
Sure. First, we put the bottle on the grill.
Oh, yes.
What if he did Chinese food, bro? That'd be crazy.
That beef and broccoli the Aki way.
Hey, let me get the
Fan Expo San Francisco 2022. It's pretty cool so far. We've been here for about 2 to 3 hours, seeing some really cool cosplay and stuff.
Sorry.
Ooh, Darth Maul is like right behind me. But so far it's been cool. Right now we have Kevin, Julius, Dante's with us. I'm Evelyn Wong from...
Hello there.
Evelyn
Wong. He set the line. He set the line there.
I was like, yo, that's crazy. That was Dante.
No.
Did you got that?
I got that. That's crazy.
Kinda dead, you have to admit that. But we're pretty prepared right now. We're on the third floor where all the autographs are being done. And we're going in to do a photo op with William Zabka, is Johnny Lawrence in Karate Kid 1, 2, and 3.
No, and Karate Kid 1 and then Cobra Kai seasons 1 through 5.
He appeared in flashbacks.
Oh, in 2, but not in 3 though.
Not in 3, oh, okay. But you get the point, it's Johnny Lawrence. So that's gonna be pretty exciting. Kevin, Dante, and then Dante's girlfriend are downstairs still. They're walking around, but we're gonna meet them here in about a little bit. But the con has been really nice. I'd say everything is pretty balanced. There's a floor for everything. Their game room was pretty small, but I think our expectations of it were pretty big because of Fanime. they had a big game room, whole thing, and like a bunch of switches, you know. But yeah, it's been pretty chill. I like it so far, and I think, to be honest, I would come to this one. This one's convenient, just in the city, and yeah, this is one that I think I'll be returning to. But hopefully in the next few clips, you'll be seeing us with Zabka.
Oh, I mean, we all
do. And you don't want to be a pussy, you want to have balls.
Hey guys, welcome. This is the first day of Vlogmas. I'm very, very excited to do this challenge because it's something that I've always considered doing, but I just haven't done it ever since I was younger. And I saw the challenge kind of popping off around 2017, 2018. I thought to myself, well, that's a lot of work. And as of right now, I feel like I've grown plentiful enough for me to be able to handle this. I think Vlogmas is gonna be a very fun challenge for myself, a new experience, and hopefully I'll have some memories in the future to cherish when the entirety of Vlogmas is done. But we're starting today off with kind of like a story really quick. Okay, so one of the stories that I have to tell. To preface, I've been working at least like 3 jobs for the past few years, or at least this past year, but I'll get into that later. But one of the jobs is that I work as a manager and barista at Share Tea. It's a bubble place, and since I'm leaving soon because I've been there for a while, I've decided that I'm gonna work there for Thanksgiving Day, and right now it's December 1st, so it's past Thanksgiving. But ever since I worked that day, we've had a really long and extraneous like rush that day, and it kind of affected my wrist a lot, and it really hurt. So that's been kind of building up, and then recently I had a shift with 2 of my coworkers. Their names are Courtney and Becky, and I was trying to be funny, and I tried to like kick one of the nozzles to our tea canisters, and in doing so I ended up falling on my left side and on my hip. I wish I had a video of it. It was actually so funny because I wasn't really in pain. I was just more so laughing. But I've been really sore, and yesterday trying to like hang out with friends and like go out and do class, like I was really pushing myself, but in reality like my body really hurt. And as of right now, it's like my body is in the healing stage, which is really nice. But I also still feel kind of like the soreness of me falling, and my wrist hasn't really gotten that much help in terms of like feeling better. I don't know how to explain it, to be honest. Just know that my body hurts. But anyways, that's kind of the story as to right now. To kind of bring about the ending is that I'm actually supposed to be at work today. I'm scheduled to open with one of my friends, Charles. I got a check for one of my other jobs, and it's on campus. Here's the thing, okay. This check, I wasn't paid it for maybe like a few months. I think this is my check from September. It's December now. So I wasn't gonna leave the house today, but this is important. I wasn't thinking that I was gonna get this check at all, but apparently it exists. So I'm gonna go to campus today to go pick it up, in which I'll lead you to my next story. I've been working 2 jobs, aside from Share Tea, making it 3, but basically I work as the photo editor at the Pioneer newspaper. Been doing it for about a few years now, and I was recruited in 2020, I believe. But I've been working there as a writer. Right now you'll probably see listed is a bunch of articles that I've written. I've written a lot of articles in the past year. So if you guys haven't been seeing my videos, I at least have some content still up. But otherwise I'm known to be their photo editor, so I usually take pictures of events that happen on campus, or if they need me to go out like and do journalism outside in Hayward. So that's my second job. My third job, and it's supposed to be technically a summer job, which is, you'll now see the irony in it, and also me picking up my check for September.
I've been working as the editor of a documentary, which is very, very exciting. At first, I was hesitant to do it, just because a lot of things in my life were happening all at once, around that time of when I was gonna get hired. It was around the time of summer, and I actually had just graduated college. I was burnt out because the previous year, I was doing a lot on campus as well. I was still working for the Pioneer, still working for Charity, and I had graduated one of the most egregious college years of my life. But nonetheless, that's the third job that I'm working. I'm working on this documentary. I'm very excited for you guys to see it. I'm not sure when it's gonna come out, but I just finished one of my last drafts last night, which is really cool. So hopefully we can see that soon, and I'm excited to share it with you guys. By the way, this is the car that I drive. It's a Mini Cooper Countryman, and his name is Coop. His name is Jonah, but a lot of us call him Coop, and by us, I mean most of my friends, just because Coop is easier. It's a Mini Cooper, but I named him Jonah because of my first car. My first car's name was Beverly. It was a white Volvo S70. Its name was Beverly because I go to campus on a hill, so I would always drive it up there, and I called it Beverly's Hill, the hill leading to my campus, because when I first drove her, the first day that I drove her, she went up it so fast. I've never gone that fast, like, on the hill. And it was really cool. But unfortunately, Beverly has exceeded her time with us and is no longer with us just because she was an older car. She's from 1998. It was a year older than me. But yeah, Coop is what I'm driving right now. Look at this building. It's so big. Probably warm and cozy in there. Hello. Picking up a check. Look, I don't know if you guys could see it, but there's like a Christmas tree in there. So I finally got my check, which is cool, but I want to listen to some music, and I can't really do it if I can't really, like, listen to music since I'm using my phone to vlog. So I have a CD collection. I'll hopefully do a video on my CD collection one day, but basically this is Biba Doobie's album. She's a rock alternative artist. It's like this. But yeah, we'll be listening to this on the way home. Vlogging with this thing is not gonna make it any easier, but really quick, just come with me to Food Max and get myself a bagel and some breakfast and then head home. Cool. So it's a bit later in the day and I'm picking up my homie. His name's Julius. You saw him earlier in the video, but I think his train
is right there. They just got here. It's in San Francisco, Daly City.
Dude, I fucking hate bug police.
What? Oh no, what
they
happened?
They stopped at, there's, I don't know, something went on at UC Bart.
Bro.
They fucking, yeah, the hella deleted it. Dude, come on.
Dude, we've been having like
hella incidents lately, bro.
Incidents, bro.
Hey, to be honest, I'm punching every guy named Julius that's standing right behind me. Please leave a like, drop.
Go. I did it.
But with the boy Julius today.
What's good?
I have an announcement for you.
What's good?
This is the first episode of Vlogmas.
Ooh, I like that.
I'm doing it.
Dude, I should fucking... what's it called? I need to do the expo still. I have hello. I need to make storage.
So later, you guys have seen it already, but later I'm gonna take you to my place. I edited it already.
You did?
Fan Expo, yeah.
All right, cool. So I need to work on mine.
We're gonna check it out.
I pull off with my nigga finna throw a fit. I pull up on the bitch, I don't say shit, she getting in. But I had to kick out, cause I tell her ass to get in. I embarrass her in front of all the friends. You see, I do a lot of shit, not just because I can.
I'ma be honest, guys, I think I can work at Walmart. I said, where's the weighing scale? He said, over there. Bruh, where over there at? Where's over there at?
I don't know.
He don't either. Okay, now that I've gotten the scale, because I need it for when I go to my trip in New York, now that I have tested it and stood on this one, we're gonna get a different one and be on our way.
Did you break it?
No, I stepped on
it. Oh, you stepped on it. Oh.
So I tried it, but I ain't using that one.
Yeah.
Someone else gonna get that one. They're gonna be like, why is there marks on this? And it's like, oh, like the people at Walmart that work there, they're gonna be like, oh, it comes like that. Why is there shoe marks on it that it comes like that? Where is it at? Over there.
Uh-oh. All right.
Why are you laughing?
Fucking terror. Your fucking face. I thought you were gonna throw it at me. I'm sorry.
You threw it at my face. You threw it at my face.
Sorry.
Bruh, everybody in Walmart, Union City, I don't want you to know. Damn, I just noticed you got the spiff hat on.
Yeah.
I didn't even know he made hats like that.
Yeah. And this is the one I got for free.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
We haven't updated you guys in a little bit, but we hung out with Christian, have just been around Union City, but we came all the way to San Leandro because we're at a spot right now. It's called Taos Fresh. Me and Julius just got our boba. Just got our boba. We didn't know that we both ordered strawberry. We got a latte though. I got a smoothie. But yeah, it's kind of like a Sicilian lunch kind of place. It has like garlic rice.
Thank you.
Do you still take a long time to get ready?
And that was it. Thank you so much, everybody that was watching and tuning in. This was Vlogmas episode 1. I hope to see you in the next one. Okay.
So we just had the funniest Target run interaction. It's so funny. So I was looking over here, and whenever I come to this aisle, the book section, I always look if they have this book. Because I've been on the search for it for a really long time. And then the homie Julius was like, oh, look what's right next to it. Because I was so flustered about the fact that I paid $27 for this. It's only 20 here. But I was so focused on that. And then Julius was like, look right next to it. And our biggest thing right now is Cobra Kai. Just know that. Because the whole video has been William Zabka. But I was like, obvious Ralph Macchio, and I was like, oh, Emily in Paris.
He said it so seriously and so confident.
It's like, oh, you're talking.
Okay, I took a long time to get ready to, cause I did remember it, and my head got heavy like it tends to do, and I know that it's far.